Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon everyone. Welcome back with me, Mr. Asep Budiman. In this occasion, we are going to continue the meeting using online presentations. Is it okay? I would like to say to you that please stay safe, stay healthy, and also stay at home, although it is weekend. This meeting, we are going to continue the lessons of accepting and declining requests by Mr. Asep Budiman. Stay with me. Accepting and declining requests. It relates to also making requests. Are you ready? Let's continue to the next slide. It's very good. First of all, let's define a request. What is a request, everyone? Have you ever made a request? Please answer my questions in the column below here. The request. Who do you make request? The request to your mother or your friends? Request. Sometimes it also in bahasa Indonesia. Requestnya apa dong? Request lagu dong. Request apalah? Request lagu. This is request. What is actually request? Before we define request, look at the illustrations of the picture here. Can you see? There is a man and also a woman. What can you see from this picture? Inside the woman's place, there is like CDs and also tape recorders, and it's like the loud sounds of the tape recorder, isn't it? Perhaps the man is requesting the woman to turn off or turn down the CD's volume or the tape recorder's volume, isn't it? This is actually a request. Have you ever done this? Okay, let's define this. A request is the act of politely or officially asking for something. Okay, when we ask for something to sometimes everyone or the other one, we call it as request. Okay, the act of asking something politely or officially. This is a request. Okay. Now let's take a look at the dialogue here. We have four people. Daddy, Mr. Phil. This one is Mrs. Phil. The green one is Jason. The purple one is Lisa. The dialogue is actually in line with the colors of their clothes. First of all, we have Mr. Phil. Jason, turn down the TV a little, please. Mr. Phil says. Jason says, this one. Oh, but this is my favorite program. Mr. Phil again. I know, but it's very loud. Jason says, okay, I'll turn it down. Mr. Phil, that's better, thanks. And the next one is this woman saying, Lisa, please pick up your things. They are all over the living room floor. This is the things, like the clothes, the book bag, something. This is the things of Lisa. Lisa said, in a minute, Mom, I'm on the phone. Mrs. Phil, okay, but do it as soon as you hang up. Lisa, sure, no problem. This conversation is inferring something. What do you infer from the conversation? Yes, exactly. It's about request. First of all, we can underline here. We can underline the word, turn down the TV a little. This is request. Mr. Phil requesting to Jason. Okay? What else? Mrs. Phil also, please pick up your things. This is also a request. Okay? And there are some requests from the dialogue. And also the response of the request. First of all, this is declining or rejecting. But this is my favorite program. Also the next one, okay, I'll turn it down. This is also accepting the request. This is sure, no problem. There are a lot of what is it? Request. It can be asking someone officially or politely, or also responding to request, can be declining or accepting. Jadi di sini dalam dialog ini ada dialog mengenai request atau permohonan atau permintaan untuk melakukan sesuatu. Pertama, Mr. Pitt menyuruh Jason untuk menyicilkan suara TV. Lalu Mrs. Pitt juga menyuruh Lisa untuk mengambil barang-barangnya di atas lantai. Itu adalah, bisa menggunakan please itu lebih sopan. Tapi langsung menggunakan turn down the TV a little please-nya di belakang juga boleh. Kalau please-nya di depan, nggak usah ada koma, please-nya di belakang ada komanya dulu. Oke, okay? This is the request. And this is the response. Respon dari request bisa menolak atau bisa menerima request, melakukan sesuai dengan apa yang diperintahkan. This is about request. Because in our daily lives, can also sometimes reject and also accept the request. Terkadang kita memohon sesuatu atau menerima permohonan atau menolak permohonan juga kan? This is actually what we are going to learn this year. The common one to make a request is request with models and would you mind. First one, we have models plus simple form. We have to be careful with model. Model is like can, could, would. But the common one is can and also could. Itu model yang paling umum digunakan untuk request. And also plus simple form of verbs. Simple form of verb itu biasanya dikatakan oleh verb 1. Verb 1. Contohnya, can you turn the stereo down? Can, setelah can diikuti oleh turn. Turn itu form 1. Bukan can turning atau turn, tapi can you turn? So, form 1. Tanda tanya, question mark. This is request. Can you turn the stereo down, please? And the next one, you can also use could. Could you leave? Walaupun pakai could, tetap akhirnya form 1, leave. Ada please-nya. Please itu menunjukkan politeness atau sopan, lebih sopan. Sama seperti ketika kita menggunakan bahasa Jawa, kromo, inggil atau kromo atau ngoko, semuanya ada tingkatannya. Di sini pakai yang lebih sopan, pakainya could. Could you leave the door open, please? Ada please-nya lebih sopan. Tapi tetap diikuti oleh verb 1 di sini, oke? Okay? Could you leave? Or you can also use would. Would you please keep the noise down? Pakai would juga lebih sopan juga. This request using can, could, would plus verb 1. Lebih ke bawah, lebih sopan. Artinya apa? Can you turn the stereo down? Bisakah kamu mengecilkan volumenya? Can you leave the door open? Could you leave the door open, please? Maaf, tolong bisa buka pintu atau pintunya biarkan terbuka? Would you please keep the noise down? Tolong dong atau mohon dong suaranya dikecilkan sedikit misalnya. Itu namanya lebih sopan. And the next one you can also use, would you mind? Would you mind? Itu suatu frasa yang tidak boleh dipisah ya. Would you mind plus gerund. Gerund itu adalah verb ing juga bisa dikatakan. Verb ing. We call it gerund. Would you mind after mind followed by verb ing? Would you mind turning? Would you mind not closing? Would you mind keeping? All of them using verb ing. Kalau yang pertama itu simple verb atau verb one. Kalau yang kedua adalah verb ing. Kalau ada would you mind. Would you mind turning the stereo down? Would you mind not closing? Would you mind keeping? Semuanya sama artinya ya. Cuma penggunaan verb ing sama verb satu yang harus hati-hati. Kalau would you mind verb ing, kalau can atau could would aja itu pakainya verb satu. Okay, this is how to make a request, the common one. Sometimes you also can use only the verb. Misalnya, turn the stereo down, please. Leave the door open, please. Tidak ada modelnya juga tidak apa-apa. Tapi ini yang lebih bagus seperti ini. And the next one, we also learn how to respond to the request. You can sometimes accept a request, menerima suatu permohonannya. You can say, okay, I'll do it for you. Sure, no problem. Of course, all right. Semuanya menerima suatu request. Atau yang lainnya juga boleh. Yang penting intinya menerima atau accept the request. Sometimes you can also decline the request. Menolak atau reject the request ya. Like, sorry, I'm busy right now. Maaf, saya sedang sibuk. Sibuk ngapain? Nggak ngapa-ngapain misalnya ya kan? Nah, biasalah. Itu namanya declining a request. Sorry, I'm busy right now. You can also say, I'm sorry, I can't. I'm afraid I can't. These are the expression of declining request. Atau yang lainnya juga sama. Yang penting intinya menolak suatu permohonan. Declining request. Okay? So we have learned how to make, how to respond both accepting also declining the request. Now we are moving to, sometimes we learn two part verbs in a request, and will correspond to request. First one, we also learn two part verbs here. Two part verbs means in the verbs there are two parts, ada frasa verbsnya. Contohnya turn down, itu adalah two part verbs atau kata kerja yang punya pasangan. Kata kerja yang punya pasangan terkadang artinya berbeda. Kalau kita punya turn down, turn itu katanya belok, tapi kalau ada down-nya menjadi kecilkan. Turn down the TV misalnya, kecilkan TV-nya atau suara TV-nya. Turn the TV down, boleh. Boleh di depan, boleh di belakang. Kalau frasanya ya. Turn down, turn on, turn off, itu semuanya two part verbs. Kalau pronoun, karena TV-nya satu, maka pakainya it ya. Turn it down. Oke, okay? Turn it down. Karena TV-nya cuma satu, pakainya it. Turn it down, sama artinya ya. Cuma bedanya ini, ada the TV noun-nya, ini pronoun atau kata gantinya, pakainya it. Juga bisa pick up your things. Pick up your things. Things-nya banyak nih, makanya pakai S. Pick up. You can also say pick your things up juga boleh. Kalau ada noun-nya, itu boleh ditaruh di depan atau di belakang noun-nya ya. Tapi kalau noun-nya atau kata bendanya berganti menjadi kata ganti pronoun, itu harus di tengah. Pick them up. Oke? Okay? Pick them up. Kenapa pakai them? Karena things-nya lebih dari satu. Oke? Okay? Pick them up. Kenapa it? Karena TV-nya satu kalau yang atas ya. Kalau yang bawah itu things-nya banyak, makanya pakai pick them up di tengah kalau pronoun. Oke? Okay? And how to respond to a request, you can use please turn down the music. Ini tanpa ada can atau could-nya juga nggak apa-apa, langsung please turn down the music. Please, taruh depan tidak usah ada koma, langsung diikuti verb 1. You can say okay, I'll turn it down. I will turn, itu bisa dikatakan I'll, apostrophe double L. Or pick up your clothes, please. Kalau ditaruh di belakang, please itu ada komanya di sini, oke? Okay? The answer, sure, I'll pick them up. Clothes-nya banyak, pakainya them. This is request and how to respond to request in two part verbs. Jadi kata kerja bisa berpasangan, dan ketika dipasangkan dengan kata yang lain, itu artinya bisa berbeda. Ya. Turn di sini, dipasangkan dengan down, itu artinya beda. Dengan turn off atau turn on. If you have any questions, you can ask in the commentary below. We go on to the exercises here. We have seen several of the things, like the books, the toys, the radio, the coat, the TV. What you have to do, you have to try to answer them by using part of verbs. For example, look at number one. Pick up blah blah blah, please. Pick up the toys, please. Pick up the toys. Okay. If you find the toys and you can see it's very messy, you can say pick up the toys, ambil. Oke? Okay? Ambillah mainannya. Pick up the toys. If you can see turn off, please. Kira-kira apa yang di-off-kan? Dari barang-barang di sini, apakah boots bisa di-off-kan? Nah, mungkin tidak bisa ya. Clean blah 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 up, please. Nah, ini juga kalau di clean up itu apa kira-kira yang di clean up? So you have to be careful with two or three part of verbs because they can have different meanings. Okay. Please do number 2 until number 6 ya. Number 2 here until number 6. Please write down your answers in the commentary below. After that, try to have conversations with your partner, making requests and also responding to requests. Okay? Okay, everyone. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you have any questions or suggestions or comments, you may do it in the commentary column below. And please subscribe, share, and also likes if you like this video. Thank you very much for watching. See you in next occasions. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.